It's been a long time to add one more video into this channel. So this program is used to understand the algorithm and also the flowchart, which finds the largest of n number. So we are not going to use any array over here. It's like we ask people or to the user to enter the values, and at the end it would show you the biggest number or the largest number of the n numbers. Okay, so this was a request from user who follows the channel, so this is for you. Maybe this would help others also. Yeah, let's go into it. So what is this actually we are doing here is, how do we move on? It's like whenever you want to read some numbers, first of all, how many numbers you want, whether it is 10 numbers, out of 10 you want to you want to figure it out, how many numbers, like whether it is 10 numbers, 20 numbers or 5 numbers, what is the n number you want to, out of n numbers which you want to figure it out as the biggest one. So first you read that and assume that the first number whatever you're reading as the biggest number. We assume the first number whatever you entered is a big biggest number. Okay, and then you start reading the other number. So whenever you read the other number, then you compare the other number with the first number. If the other number is greater than the first number, then you make the biggest number as the other number, and you do go on doing it until you reach all the numbers, or all the numbers you want have been entered by the users. So at the last you just print what is the biggest number. That's the small algorithm which we go through it. So yes, so let's move on to the example and I'll understand you. So assume that you want, you out of four numbers you want to find the biggest number, so n is equal to 4, and the first number whichever you are entering is the assigning it as a biggest number. So you are for entering a first number as 25 and you are making it as a biggest. So understanding that biggest, now what you have to do is you have to now go for the second number, third number and fourth number. So whenever you read second number you have to compare it, whenever you're reading third number you have to compare with the biggest number, whenever you're reading the fourth number you have to compare. So that in that way it has to repetitive. So whenever it is repetitive, then what you have to do is you have to take another variable I which is equal to 2. Why I'm taking it as 2? Because already I have first number, biggest is my first number, so I just want to go with the second number, third number, fourth number till n number. Okay, so that's why I is equal to 2 I took. So now as I was saying, first is the biggest number, so that would be your biggest number, that would be your output biggest number. I next, you are reading, you are going with the first iteration, that means I is equal to 2 now. So when I is equal to 2 you have read one number which is equal to 35. So now this 35 you have to come check whether the biggest number is less than n or not. So 25 is less than 35, true or false? Yes, it is true. So as it is true, now you have to make it as what? Biggest is equal to num. So now your biggest number becomes 35. So now it is I is equal to 2 but n is equal to 4. You have to iterate next, you have to go for the second iteration. So in the second iteration your I becomes 3, I becomes 3 because we started with 2, right? So this is 2 and this is 3. So your second iteration is 15. So what is your biggest number here? 35. You have to compare. 35 is less than 15. 35 is less than 15. True or false? It is false. So you are not going to make anything here. Biggest is equal to, now you are not doing any assignment. So now the biggest remains the same, which is 35. Now you are going for the third iteration. So in the third iteration you took 10. And now when it is 10, so you are checking whether it is 35 less than or equal to 10. So again it is false, so your biggest number becomes 35. That is how the biggest number looks like. So now we are overall by the end of these all iterations, all now n is equal to 4. Can you see? First time it is first number, second number, third number and fourth number, n is equal to 4, finished. So once you have read 4 numbers, you got the biggest number as 35 and you can print that 35. The same thing we will see in the algorithm. Step 1, you read n numbers and then read first number as biggest number and then assign I is equal to 2. So you are at this place. So you read first number as equal to 25 and then I is equal to 2. Okay, and then repeat this step until I is less than or I is less than or equal to n. So now I is what? 2. 2 is less than or equal to, for example, you said 4. So 2 is less than 4. Yes, less than or equal to 4. It is true. So if it is true, you have to continue. So read another number as num. Read another number as num and check if biggest is less than or equal to num. You can take equal to num here. Check if biggest is less than or equal to num. Then if it is true, again continue. So biggest is equal to num, you will assign it. So assign biggest is equal to num. Then I is equal to I plus 1, increment the I. Again go to repeat the step 4. So now this becomes 3 less than or equal to 4. Yes, it is true. Again you read this. Again check whether it is greater than or num. Biggest is less than or equal to num. If it is false, go to step 8 and increment it. Now it becomes 4. 4 less than or equal to 4. Yes, it is true. So read another number and check. So for example, assume that it is false and you go to step 8. If I is equal to I plus 1, then it becomes 5. So 5 less than or equal to 4, then it is false. You will go to step 9. And now you will print the biggest number, whichever it is, as biggest. And then step 9, you will stop. So let's see the flowchart. The same thing, you will read n numbers, read the first number as biggest, I is equal to 2, and check whether I is less than or equal to n. If it is true, you will read another number, then biggest is less than or equal to num, you will check. If it is true, you will assign biggest is equal to num, and then you will go to I is equal to I plus 1, and then again you will check it, whether it is true or false. If it is false, you will print the biggest number, which is came up. And I forgot to end this particular flowchart. Here you will find the end shape. Okay, so this is how your program C program looks like. So you can take this. So I took void, you can even add int main and add extra thing as return is equal to 0. Let's execute this. Yes, so this is the one which we have taken. So this one number I took because to understand what number it is. First number, second number I want to check. So that's why I took here one, and then rest of the things I'll add I as the number. So we can just go with the execution. So let me compile this. So yes, there are no errors and warnings. So let me go for run. So here you will see it will ask you to enter the first number, enter the values of, first of all it will ask the enter the values. So I'll take 4, so as in my example. So enter first number, I'll add enter first number as 25, and that becomes the biggest. Enter 32nd number, so I'll take 35. Now 35 becomes the biggest. Then now I'll enter 20, and then I'll enter 10. So number 4 numbers I haven't asked, so no 4 numbers I got. Now the answer you will see is largest number is 35. This is how you do the find the biggest or largest of n numbers. Okay, thank you.